and trade it in for joy. Oh, only you can do it. Only you can do it. Only you can do it. And all these pieces broken and scattered, mercy gathered, mended and whole. Empty-handed, but not forsaken. I've been set free. I've been set free. Oh, amazing grace. How sweet the sound that saved like me. Oh, I once was lost, but now I am found. Was blind, but now I see. I can see you now. I can see the saved a wretch like me. Whoa. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. no accusation.
Saved a wretch like me.
and stars they were. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was falling. His body on the cross, his blood poured out for us. The weight of every curse upon him. Thank you.
blind, but now Father, we thank you that you are a God that is alive. Lord, you are a God that is alive. And Father, you are a God that relates to us personally, that has come down here on this earth to bring salvation for us. And Father, you choose to dwell with us in our hearts today. You choose to continue this relationship, and you choose to pour out your grace and your mercy and your love, Lord God, day in and day out. And Father, we just thank you so much that we get to enjoy this relationship with you, a God that is so alive in us. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now we will spend time to worship in the Word. Please open to Psalm 27. Psalm chapter 27. Psalm chapter 27, verse 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Lord Jesus, we thank you for being our salvation. When we were in debt to you, you created a way for us to be saved, for our sins to be taken up on the cross, and you were crucified. You did away with all of our sins. Thank you, Lord. And now we know you in your resurrection and have received the great gift of grace. You are our light. You offer to live inside of us and shine your light, to bring the warmth of your peace and to bring the light into the dark corners of our flesh, to light the way through paths of righteousness. There is nothing we should fear.
Security.
27 verses 2 and 3. When the wicked advance against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall. Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war break out against me, even then I will be confident. For as long as we live in the world, we will face persecution. We will face adversity. But no matter how hard they try, they will fall at the feet of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus, and you have already won the victory. Knowing this, our hearts will not fear, our minds will not shrink away, but will stand firm. We will stand our ground as mighty warriors, ready to win the battle, going forward already knowing who will be victorious. No battle is too big, no war is too much, for you are God who goes before us and stands beside us. In this we are fully confident.
Oh, I place my confidence in the name of the Lord. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I fear.
chapter 27, verses 4. One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek Him in His temple. Lead me, O Lord. Show us where you are. Show us the place in which you dwell, and may we dwell there with you all the days of our lives. Open the doors and reveal yourself to us. Reveal the details of the house in which you dwell. May we gaze upon your beauty and not know how to turn our face away. Take away the veils from our eyes, the dust of the earth, and the lenses that we have put on. Whatever it may be, unforgiveness, bitterness, hurt, pain, trauma, we lay it all down at your feet so that we may see you rightly. See you rightly, Jesus, in your majesty.
To be here with you, oh God. desire a one thing kind of heart, a one thing kind of heart. A one thing kind of heart, a one thing kind of heart. Oh, I desire a one thing kind of heart, a one thing kind of heart. I desire kind of heart, one thing kind of heart. Oh, I desire one thing kind of heart, one thing kind of heart. Oh, knowing you are more than enough, fix on you, oh God. The joy set before me, the joy set before me, the joy set before me. You are, you're the joy set before me, the joy set before me, the joy set before me. Joy set before me, the joy set before me, the joy set before me. You are, you're the joy set before me, the joy set before me, the joy set before me. You are, the joy set before me, the joy set before me, the joy set before me. You are, the joy set before me, the joy set before me, the joy set before me.
Joy, you are my joy.
the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his sacred tent and set me high upon a rock. Then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. At his sacred tent, I will sacrifice with shouts of joy. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Come what may, in the days where no one can find refuge, you will show us where you are dwelling. You will lead the way into your house. You are our cornerstone and our strong foundation. You are our strong refuge. You will hide us, giving us a peace that is unheard of. Though we will hear of battles and wars, your people will be hidden and kept safe. You will set us high upon a rock, and our spirits will sing praises to you, who is King of Kings, Lord of Lords.
Spirit of wisdom,
cause I know that
satisfy my soul. You satisfy my soul. You satisfy my soul with your love. You satisfy my soul. You satisfy my soul. You satisfy my soul with your love. You satisfy my soul. You satisfy my soul. You satisfy my soul with your love. You satisfy my soul. You satisfy. Satisfy my soul with your love. And you make my heart sing. You lift me on eagle's wings. Just when I thought that my heart it would fail. And you take the darkest night and turn it to shining. Just when I thought that the night had won, you satisfy my soul. You satisfy my soul. You satisfy my soul with your love. You satisfy my soul. You satisfy. Just when I thought
Sometimes
will be going into a time to pray for Israel. And we will be praying for the revelation of the full gospel over Israel. And with the same faith that you have and the satisfaction that you have in the Lord right now in this moment as we worship Him and saying, "You satisfy my soul," may that be your prayer as you take this opportunity to take up your authority in Christ and receive God's heart for Israel. May that be your prayer for Israel. And as we give our full attention to those whom God calls the apple of His eyes, let's pray knowing that the end is near. As I lead out in prayer, come into agreement with me, and afterwards, please lift up your own intercession to the Lord. We acknowledge that, Lord, you are creator of the universe. There was nothing before you, absolutely nothing. And with one word, you commanded the heavens and the earth into being. You are God, three in one. We pray that in this truth would be acknowledged, that this truth would be acknowledged by men and women in Israel, that there would be even a wrestling with the truth, that as scholars who hear of you, that they would weigh it beside other gods and other religions, and they would know that you are the truth, that you would be made known to them. As persecution comes from all sides for Israel, would you release a desire to know the truth and find purpose in their existence, to know you and to love you, all of who you are. Holy Spirit, would you reveal yourself in signs and wonders, in visions and dreams. Lead your people to Christ and the revelation of God the Father, Holy Spirit, and Jesus Christ. Let's pray. And fall short of the glory of God, it says in Romans 3:23. may this revelation come to the lost in Israel and to your sons and daughters who have turned from your ways. Would you humble your people to come before you sober, broken, and torn, to find strength in you and you alone, to find a yearning for freedom because they were made for freedom. We pray for a hunger for the kingdom, a hunger to put to death the ways of the flesh, and a hunger for purity and righteousness because we were made for glory. Let's pray. Would be heard all throughout the land. May Christ be proclaimed day and night in Israel. The message of the cross gives us hope in that we don't need to do anything to be worthy of salvation. We are worthy and simply need to receive. And so we declare that this amazing grace be extended to Israel. This is our joy, that it is for by grace we are saved and only through the work of the cross. On street corners, in theaters, on pulpits, in auditoriums and stadiums, would you preach this good news? May the gospel be shared with great boldness and rejoicing this holiday season. We pray for a fresh grace and anointing over Messianic Jews to boldly speak of your salvation, the gift of salvation. Let's pray.
Thank you.
are your firstborn and they are yours, Lord God. Father, you are not one to turn back on your promises, but you are here, Lord God, to reveal to us that you are to fulfill, you are going to fulfill your promises, Lord God, for Israel. We thank you, Father, that you have a powerful revelation, Lord God, revelation of God and the revelation of sin and the revelation of salvation, Lord God, for them. And in this Christmas season, we pray, Lord, that there would be a melting of hearts, Lord, that hearts would be turned to you, that eyes would see, ears would hear, and that the word of God would fall powerfully on good soil. We thank you, Lord, that even in this room, Lord God, you're empowering us today to speak the word with boldness, to speak the full gospel, the message of salvation. And so I pray that as we walk out this door, Father, our eyes will be set on the promises that are before us, Lord. And that, Lord, our hearts would just burst, Lord God, with joy and love, Lord God, to share the good news, Lord God, to those around us, Lord. We thank you. We love you so much, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Father, we confess before you that you are the one thing that we desire and will seek after. That as we dwell in your presence and as we make you our refuge and our stronghold, all fear melts away, all confusion, all anxiety has no place in your presence. We thank you, God, that the more we see you, we see it just how worthy you are, just how beautiful, how worthy of all the sacrifice, all the honor and all the praise you are. We thank you that you make it easy for us to worship you. Continue to draw our hearts closer to you. Continue to purge our hearts of every other lover, every other idol, every other desire outside of you. May we seek you first and foremost, that our days as we walk with you would be days where we are fixed on the prize that is set before us, the joy that has been set before us. We thank you, God. We love you. We do all these things for you and for you alone. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you guys for joining us tonight. We hope that you are blessed in going deeper into the Word and into intercession. Next week, next Thursday evening is actually Christmas Eve, and we haven't really announced it yet, but Christmas Eve, we will be having a watch, and if you don't have any Christmas Eve plans, I encourage you to come out. It's going to be a really sweet way to spend Christmas Eve, just in God's presence and singing happy birthday to Him, I guess. So we'd love for you guys to join. Next week, we'll be having our Wednesday morning watch as well at 9:30 in the morning. And our Thursday evening, as always, is at 8 p.m. So we'll see you guys next week. Have a wonderful day.